You know, I'm still standing better than I ever did. Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. And I'm still standing after all this time, picking up the pieces of my life.
Today is Wednesday, April 12th, 2023. My name is Kaden. Happy birthday to Raylan and Mrs. Arbonia's class, and Tegan and Mrs. Schramm's room. Now listen closely to today's announcement about humility.
Tim McGraw has a song called Humble and Kind that has the lyric, "Don't take for granted the love that life gives you. When you get where you're going, don't forget to turn back around and help the next one in line. Always stay humble and kind." When you accomplish something worthwhile, it can be easy to focus on yourself and enjoy all the accolades coming to you. But I love how this reminds us to help others along the way. Our success can be useful to others on the same path as us.
Things that make you go, what? April 12th, 1861. Four of the bloodiest years in American history began when Confederate shore batteries under General P.G.T. Beauregard opened fire on Union-held Fort Sumter in South Carolina's Charleston Harbor on April 12, 1861. During the next 34 hours, 50 Confederate guns and mortars launched more than 4,000 rounds at the poorly supplied fort. On April 13, U.S. Major Robert Anderson surrendered the fort. 2 days later, U.S. President Abraham Lincoln issued a proclamation calling for 70,000 volunteer soldiers to quell the Southern insurrection. As early as 1858, the ongoing conflict between the North and the South over the issue of slavery had led Southern leadership to discuss a unified separation from the United States. By 1860, the majority of the slave states were publicly threatening secession if the Republicans, the anti-slavery party, won the presidency. Following Republican Abraham Lincoln's victory over the divided Democratic Party in November of 1860, South Carolina immediately initiated secession proceedings. On December 20th, the South Carolina's legislature passed the Ordinance of Secession, which declared that the Union now subsisting between South Carolina and other states under the name of the United States of America is hereby dissolved. After that declaration, South Carolina set about seizing forts, arsenals, and other strategic locations within the state. Within 6 weeks, five more southern states, Mississippi, Florida, Alabama, Georgia, and Louisiana, had followed South Carolina's lead. In February of 1861, delegates from those states convened to establish a unified government. Jefferson Davis of Mississippi was subsequently elected the first president of the Confederate States of America. When Abraham Lincoln was inaugurated on March 4, 1861, a total of seven states, Texas had joined that pack, had seceded from the Union, and federal troops held only Fort Sumter in South Carolina, Fort Pickens off the Florida coast, and a handful of minor outposts in the South. 4 years after the Confederate attack on Fort Sumter, the Confederacy was defeated at the total cost of 620,000 Union and Confederate soldiers dead.
Let's end today's announcements by remembering the STAR expectations. Today and every day, strive to do your best.
Take responsibility for your actions.
Always be safe.
Respect people and property. Have a great day, Bearsville.
Now please stand for the playing of the national anthem, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance.